my view, ladies and gentlemen, in the development of any nation, any country, three institutions play a critical role: the state, the market, and the civil society. In various societies, these three wings have been accorded varying degrees of emphasis and power. We've had dictatorships all over the world until about 20 years ago. Until 1991 in India, though we were democratic, the state was supreme and was accorded exceptional importance with overall unsatisfactory, there were good things, but overall unsatisfactory economic and social results. India realized, just as the world realized, that there is little choice but to bow to the diktat of the market. Democracy is an important mechanism to both shape and control the state, but we know how ineffective democracy can be and how corrupting power is. Yet democracy is the best option for governance in a society. The market is an institution that on the whole works better, in my view, than the state, because fundamentally in the market, no entity has a monopoly. It encourages and rewards innovation and talent. And with the coming of the knowledge economy, the balance between capital and talent is shifting steadily in favor of talent, all for the good. But the market, unfortunately, also has its drawbacks. To be fair and efficient, it needs to be regulated.
Uttar Pradesh mein Baniya jile ke niwasi Ravin Bhai, मूलतः एक रचनात्मक कार्यकर्ता तथा एक आंदोलनकारी कमिश्नर है, जो मुझे खून दो मैं आजादी दूंगा कहने वाले नेताजी सुभाष चंद्र बोस के आह्वान पर स्वतंत्रता आंदोलन में कूद पड़े। 1948 में गांधी जी के निधन के बाद रवीन भाई ने अहिंसावादी तरीकों से राष्ट्र सेवा के प्रति अपने जीवन को पुनः समर्पित करने का निर्णय लिया।
बयालीस में मुझे याद है, मैं इसी मुंबई में एक साल था, भूमिगत था, वो जमाना कुछ और था, विस्तार से करने की जरूरत नहीं है। ठीक है, विरोधी माने जाते थे, जहां तक हिंसा अहिंसा का सवाल था, आजादी में जरूर घूमने। बाद में जब कॉलेज में पहुंचा तो धीरे धीरे जरूर समझ में आने लगा कि लगता है कि गांधी जी का रास्ता सही है। हिंसा अहिंसा मुझे नहीं मालूम, लेकिन गांधी जी जो कर रहे हैं कुछ हो रहा है। उसमें आने के बाद फिर ठीक है, यूनिवर्सिटी में पहुंचने तक अहिंसा का रास्ता कुछ समझ में आने लगा, उधर कुछ काम करने लगा, आज़ादी भी हुई। लेकिन आज़ादी के बाद जो सोचा था कि एक ईमानदार दुनिया होगी, समाज होगा, ऐसे ही कुछ व्यापार होगा, मैंने उसमें पैर लगाया तो देखा कि जहाँ जाते हैं वहीं बेईमानी है, जहाँ जाते हैं वहीं बेईमानी है। इससे छुटकारा कैसे मिले?
विनायक पाटिल has dedicated the last 30 years of his life to the promotion of cooperative agroforestry, of eucalyptus trees, for bringing about a socio-economic and ecological development in India. He is indeed a pioneer in this field. He established the Nashik District Eucalyptus Growers Cooperative Society in 1983. As many as 15 million eucalyptus trees have been planted by the Nashik Society so far, inspired by the remarkable achievements. Over 25 million growers and cooperatives have been formed in the state of Maharashtra alone. Research has already been undertaken by Shri Patil for evolving high-quality planting materials and salt-tolerant facilities. An organization for preparing seedlings through tissue culture has already been set up by him. Saline and waterlogged areas have now been brought under newly developed varieties. No wonder the FAO has commended Vinayak Patil's work in agroforestry by mentioning it in the title, Marketing in Forestry and Agriculture.
अवार्ड मिलने से मैं खुश हूं और खुद को खुश नसीब भी महसूस कर रहा हूं। मैं खुश इसलिए हूँ कि 25 साल से ज़्यादा समय मैंने कृषि वानिकी के इस विषय में व्यतीत किया है। शुरुआत में कभी मुझे काफ़ी आलोचना को भी झेलना पड़ा। जब आप कोई अनजान राहों पे चलते हो तो आलोचना का होना स्वाभाविक भी है। यह पुरस्कार मेरे लिए दवा है और असर तो दोनों का भी है, असर दवा का भी है और असर दुआ का भी है।
A teacher by profession, Shrimati Alice Garg entered the field of social service in 1972 with a paltry sum of 5,000 rupees. But more important and more enduring, within her was a deep and burning desire to bring hope and happiness into the lives of children of the socially backward and the economically deprived communities, children living in abject poverty. For this work in 1972, Shrimati Garg founded the Bal Rashmi Society with the motto, Save Children, Save Generation. Soon the numbers in her care increased from just 4 to nearly 200. Many orphaned, all destitute.
बापू की बेटी हूँ जिन्होंने कभी भी पीछे नहीं देखा, सीने पे गोली खाई है पर किसी को वो नहीं किया। तो जो स्थिति ये रही है और जो आ रही है, जिससे सबको हम गांधी विचारधारा के लोगों को घबराहट है थोड़ी सी, उसके लिए आपने जो ये हम लोगों को चुना है वो हम गांधी परिवार से जुड़ करके अपने आप को बहुत गौरवान्वित मानते हैं। और हमें उनके काम के साथ साथ ये समझ में नहीं आता था कि एक के बाद एक जो समस्या हमारे सामने आ जाती थी और एक दूसरे से उलझी भी होती थी, हम उसको कैसे हल करें। लेकिन हमने हिम्मत नहीं हारी और उनके साथ बैठ कर के उसके हल ढूंढने की कोशिश करी, क्योंकि ये समस्याएं कुछ तो हम जान गए थे काम करते करते, लेकिन जैसे जैसे उनको जानते थे वो और भी जटिल होती जाती थी और भी समस्याएं नई नई सामने आ जाती थी।
An outstanding civil rights leader in the USA, prize-winning author and political scientist, Professor Mary King had the distinction of working alongside the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Needless to say, her book won the prestigious 1988 Robert F. Kennedy Memorial Book Award. Now, Professor of Peace and Conflict Studies at the University for Peace of the United Nations, in Costa Rica, Professor King also serves as a special advisor to the rector. Nonviolent transformation of conflict, international peace studies, gender and peace building are some of the offbeat but fascinating subjects that she teaches at UPeace, where she is also an academic advisor to the university's Africa program. A tireless traveler over the past 2 decades, Professor King has visited more than 120 countries in connection with her work.
Now, I was reminded as I flew from Durban to Mumbai that Gandhi had sought to come from Durban to Mumbai in 1894. He was just leaving when he learned that the Natal legislative body was about to pass legislation that would disenfranchise the Indians living in Natal. He was then 25, 3 years older than I was when I went to work for the civil rights movement. And I think that that is my message to you today, that Gandhi belongs to the whole world. And having studied Gandhian theories, I know how insightful and shrewd was Gandhi and how he has expanded the political imagination of persons concerned with lasting, durable social justice worldwide.
The work
spans for different parts of the world. The intellectual world has great substance. The intellectual work is not merely intellectual, but it is work of commitment. Since a great deal of our work has been with Martin Luther King Jr., I must recall one thing that he told me in Geneva, where we spent a week together on the invitation of His Holiness the Pope at that time. We spent a whole week talking about things and cabbages, and he said, "You know, Mahatma Gandhi brought back Jesus Christ in my life." That was a very deeply moving observation, for he thought his mission in life was to be ordained. In 1931, Mahatma Gandhi had a dream. He dreamt of an India in which the poorest would feel that it was their country, in whose making they would have an effective voice, an India where there will be no higher or lower classes of people, an India where there will be no curse of untouchability, an India where women would enjoy the same rights as men, an India which would be in peace with the rest of the world, neither exploiting nor being exploited, requiring the smallest army imaginable. He said, and I quote, "I shall be satisfied with nothing less," unquote. It was his dream which led millions of Indians to fight under his leadership, the most formidable imperial power of the world, not with arms, but with ahimsa. The world looked with amazement at this struggle between David and Goliath, which was so unequal, so uneven, and seemingly so predetermined. It observed utter disbelief and bewilderment when sheer moral authority humbled the fierce brute force of the imperial power with all humility and compelled it to transfer power to India.
Our laureates choose to remain away from the focus of publicity, but the world must refuse to forget them and bestow them with the richly deserved honor and glory as the true champions of Mother India. Today, in our own humble way, we have done just that. So ladies and gentlemen, may I invite you to salute them with a warm acclamation.